thorn, you know the silver flag. But it wasn't a woody thorn. It was someone else entirely, and he had basic knowledge of antiques. And he said, what have you got, lads? And he could smell that we'd been drinking. He was perhaps a little suspicious. And I said, I've got this watch my grandfather left me, and I took it out of the brown paper envelope, saying, to be left to JT when I die. And I show him it, and he says, okay. You join that queue over there. And we're in the good queue. We're in the special queue. If Michael Douglas had been there, he would have been in that queue. Or Michael Jackson, if he'd been alive, he would have been in that queue. Or Michael Johnson, is he a basketball player? He would have been in that queue. Or Michael Galloway, Vic Galloway, the Radio 1 DJ, he would have been in that queue. In fact, the only people who wouldn't be in that queue was you. But we were in that queue. We were getting pretty excited, and when we got to the front of the queue, it turned out that we needed makeup and shit. It was quite incredible. And you know, underneath this hat, I'm a bald guy, and they put lots and lots of makeup on top of my bald patch. And I was thinking, this is very exciting. I'm gonna look like Clive Anderson or one of these people who haven't got any hair, but miraculously looks as though they have got hair. And Neil gets some makeup as well. And I say, how's he coming? Why's he coming? And they say, oh, it always looks good if there's two of you on telly. It always looks good like there's a buddy story. And they sit us down on a very small stool, just the two of us perched together, very closely, but I've known him for years, so it's not a problem. But then back in my mind, I'm thinking, perhaps they've got a certain amount of homosexuals they have to have in every show. And they saw me and Neil, and they said, look, you will do. So I'm sitting beside Neil. And one of the guys comes out, I think it was Eric Knowles. Knowles, he's from the deli, check him out, look at his moustache. He's a real man, he hardly looks at us, but he's a real man, he's got dandruff, but he's a real man. In a light checked brown suit. Cameras, action, rolling. Okay, and we start getting a bit nervous. And Neil said, wash your seat, Jimsy. I said, don't say anything, Neil, it's all right. I doubt very much they'll ask you anything. You just keep quiet, okay? It'll be fine. This'll be funny. And they ask me what my name is, and I make up a name. I say, my name is Johnny Lynch. Because I thought it'd be funny, I thought it'd be an in-joke. I thought people would see it and say, hey, there's James Yorkston. And then they'd say, what's your name? I'd say, Johnny Lynch. And perhaps if some of you were watching and you were hungover or stuff, you'd go, what's happened? Has my mind rearranged? Has everything gone wrong? Has everything gone different? But anyway, so Mr. Lynch, will you tell me about this watch? Yes, I can tell you about the watch that I left it by my grandfather. And he was awarded it for some brave deed in the Second World War by the Swiss government. And it's made by that famous one, not Rolex, the other one. And it's pure gold, and it's got a wee diamond in it. And he starts getting a wee bit excited. And I think, help my boy, he might be on telly, and he tells us all a wee bit about it. And he says, so Mr. Lynch, would you like to know how much this is worth? Purely for insurance value alone, you understand? And I said, of course, I would never sell it. And he says, would it be a surprise to you if I told you it was worth £30,000? And my friend Neil says, very, very loudly. My friend Neil says, very, very loudly, thus ruining my chance of ever being on telly. My friend Neil says, very, very loudly, and everyone looks at him, and his cheeks go red. Can you guess what my friend Neil says? My friend Neil said, shit, I can't!